Hello, we are Team MIST Mongol Barota from Bangladesh, and this year we are back with our highly sophisticated Rover Phoenix 2.0. Welcome to our 2022 System Acceptance Review.
After a huge success last year, this year we have a bigger and assorted team of over 60 students who have worked extremely hard to make Phoenix 2.0 significantly different and better than our Rover last year.
Previously, Phoenix weighed 54 kg, whereas Phoenix 2.0 weighs 50 kg in total and 42 kg in a single mission. The full mechanism of Phoenix 2.0 has three parts: the body, arm, and sides. Instead of ball joints, this year we use bevel gear, which keeps the whole system compact, preventing wastage of space. Our rocker bogey is made of stainless steel, and a ladder structure has been used for higher strength and stability of the rocker arm.
Our wheel is made of 3D printed honeycomb structure tires using thermoplastic polyurethane material and custom-made rim using stainless steel that uses suspension mechanism for shock absorbing. The 2 degrees of freedom wheel provides stability and flexibility in rotational and steering movement. Stepper motor is used along with the DC motor to steer each wheel independently, which helps to rotate the rover 360 degrees.
Phoenix 2.0 has 5 degrees of freedom arm with 2 links. This year, aluminium and carbon fiber have been used for a lighter weight and easier movement. Spar gear mechanism with a gear ratio of 5:1 has been used in the arm base for higher torque and viability. 2 linear actuators and 4 steppers have been used in the arm, one in the base and the other 3 in the end effector that uses a differential bevel gear mechanism. The arm is strong enough to tow and lift a payload over 8 kg. In addition to opening a drawer and inserting cash in it, the arm is also capable of performing other sophisticated tasks like handling USB, push switch, tightening of a screw, joystick control, knob and flip switch, and typing on a keyboard. This year, our end effector uses a worm gear mechanism to grip objects up to 5.12 inches wide with strength and precision.
This year, in our autonomous navigation, we improved localization, computer vision, and navigation capabilities to ensure smoother traversal than last year. Camel's filter fuses the data from the onboard GPS, and the integrated IMU in jet provides proper positioning to gain accurate GNSS. A custom script publishes the sensor data in ROS to navigate to the visual markers. Simultaneous localization and mapping using the combined data from depth sensing along with the LiDAR and point clouds can detect and avoid any obstacles to the waypoints. 2D pose estimation and multi-marker detection are combinedly used to identify air tags up to 5 to 10 meters distance. 3 LEDs have been integrated in the rover for indicating successful arrival to the destination.
The prime communication system of Phoenix 2.0 uses a 2.4 GHz omnidirectional antenna in both the rover and base station. The effective range of the communication module has been tested to be 1 km, and 4 cameras have been used along with 2 FPV cameras of 5 GHz.
The main focus of the electrical subsystems is the control of the rover and integration of core electronics and embedded systems. Enhanced modularity is implemented using various custom PCBs and SolidWorks electrical 3D facilitating simulation of real-time electrical wiring of the rover. Besides allowing 120 minutes of operation, lithium polymer batteries also power a modular electronic architecture. Moreover, our custom power distribution board also prevents issues such as mismatched battery voltages and subsystem level shorts. For emergency stop of the rover, we also have a kill switch.
In order to minimize complexity, the 5 degrees of freedom arm uses a specialized gripper to collect soil samples. A testing chamber has been mounted on the back of the rover to detect biomolecules from rock and soil samples. The samples are each deposited into 3 isolated beakers for the detection of biomolecules with chemical tests. This involves carbohydrate using Benedict solution, protein using ninhydrin solution, and ammonia using litmus strips. The results are streamed back to the base station for immediate evaluation to feed back as input into our customized algorithm, and the samples are classified into extinct, extant, and no presence of life.
To analyze the rock sample, a USB microscope with the addition of MVOC sensors have been mounted with the end effector to analyze and detect the presence of living microorganisms from rock sample. A neural network model with transfer learning has been made with our custom dataset of 998 rock samples, predicting the category and identifying fossilized samples with 97.3% accuracy. Moreover, a muscle chart is used to detect the level of total organic carbon present in rock samples. A sample acquisition and analysis process is being tested on a course with marked soil and rock samples.
As the final master here, we plan to fully focus on practicing a series of mock missions under the same constraints that we expect at the competition. Different conferences and workshops are also being hosted as a part of our educational outreach plan. We believe in our capability and effort. On behalf of MIST Mongol Barota, thank you for your consideration. See you in the finals.